looks like a bit of me. Ham chops. There we go, that'll do.
Right. Welcome back everyone to another Sea West adventure. Well, that's comfortable. As you can probably tell, I'm back at that campground in my last van camp video. I just had to come back and check this place out. It's just an awesome spot, and as you can tell now, I'm right down the back corner against the tree line here. Isolated down the back here, there's no one else here tonight, and we actually have a cyclone hitting us. I'm not sure how bad we're going to get it on this side of the coast, but there should be some rain and there should be some heavy gusts probably moving in tomorrow. Right now it's about 15 knots. You probably can't tell because of my microphone up here, but it is windy as hell. The first things first, I'm going to get my tarp set up, get my shelter set up in case that rain comes early. So looking, the forecast is a little bit up and down. We may not see any rain tonight, or they may be completely wrong and we have some nice decent showers like we did last time. I've learned not to trust the meteorologists here in New Zealand. Anyway, beautiful spot. We've got some beautiful food. I'm looking forward to this trip. It's gonna be a good one. So I'm gonna get my tarp up, set everything else up, all my beds set up. I do that before I leave. I got my EcoFlow unit once again, which is powering my fridge at the moment, which is ice cold. Got some nice lamb chops in there that I crumb myself for dinner, and some other trappings on the side of that. Right, let's get this tarp up. There it is. Right, what we'll do is we'll get our pegs, because we're going to need, they're there. Made sure I put them up top. First things first, I need to peg the back corners down over here. I think it's going to be a little tricky with this wind. What we want to do is get that up over, keep the tension on it. Get him up and over like that. I keep tangling myself in these ropes because of my shoes. Get him over here, just to keep it out of the way for now. Peg this down over here. I can't push him too hard with my slides. I should have my shoes on, but I don't know where they are, somewhere in there. Put that back there. Now, it needs to go that way, obviously. Man, it is windy. Super windy. Get that about there. Need to even this up before I go ahead with staking the front out. That way it's nice and even. There we go. Nice and even, Stephen. Get our pole, which is in here somewhere. That one in a pole. Need to wait for those gusts to drop off, otherwise it just put so much weight on the tarp. Okay. Get some pressure off this corner. So that's where the wind's hitting it at the moment. The wind direction is actually gonna come from the back. It's gonna come from this way, so we should be sheltered when the winds pick up later. Man, that's a strong gust. Okay, now we're getting somewhere. Bit difficult in the wind, isn't it? Okay. Ideally, that tensions it up a bit more. This one can go that way, tension up a bit. Okay, now we're getting somewhere. Yeah, those paracord are tight. When the wind does pick up, we'll have to go over it. I'm going to put my cardboard protectors under those points of the boot lid. What have we got? This time I brought a little mat for out here. I can take my shoes off. Now we need our table and chair. I'm going to turn this fridge off too. Heaps of battery left. Wasn't fully charged, but I don't need to with the EcoFlow. I think it's at about 82%, so I know that there's a lot of energy left in that. Right, I'll get my chair set up. Important piece of the kit. Okay, now where's our table? Table is here somewhere. Check around that side. This. Oh, this is nice. Hopefully you can hear me okay. I've changed the setting on the audio, but that was pointed out by Tony from AB Camping. You notice my audio was a bit tinny, so I found out that my wind filter setting was still activated on my camera, and it shouldn't be when I'm using the wireless system. So hopefully the audio is sounding a lot better. I did give it a test earlier and it sounded much more crisp with a bit more bass. So apologies if it was a bit raspy tinny last time. And I know I'm gonna move my microphone when I'm eating. I'm gonna put it on my waist or something, because some of you don't enjoy the munching and chewing and swallowing noises. So I apologize for that. I don't mean to do it. It's the microphone's super sensitive. Okay. Well, I think I'm just gonna go over a little bit of adjustment on the tarp, but it looks pretty good. Just wanna see if I can lift it up off these points, and I'll put my cardboard protectors over there and we should be good to go from there. What's the time? 4:30, so we have around about 2 hours of light left. Yeah, about 2 hours or so. So the plan is to just relax. I'm gonna have a bit of a drink, have a bit of an unwind. I've had a busy day and I just had to get out here, always chasing the weather. So I'm pretty exhausted, but I'm gonna push through it. I'm happy to be here and I got this marvelous view. Check this out. Got some big foothills here. The spot is called the Waitakere Ranges. And this isn't far from where I live here in Auckland, in New Zealand, in the North Island of New Zealand. It's been my playground most of my life, pretty much all my life. Been coming out here fishing along the coastlines and bushwalks and all that kind of stuff. And now, 31 years old, I'm still in here mucking around, playing with tarps and tents and cooking things and having the time of my life, to be quite honest. All right, I'm gonna get a drink out. Fridge is ice cold. There's actually ice on the side of it, which is probably a bit too cold. I've got some nice dinner. Check that. It's ice cold. Right, so as you would have seen, in the beginning of the video, I went to the supermarket right before this trip. I shot in there, parked the van up, ran in, and my local butcher was shut, so I ended up getting some lamb chops, which I've got for dinner. And I actually stopped in at home and crumbed them. So I use a egg, flour and bread crumb mix, just a panko crumb. The reason I did that at home is because it'll make a hell of a mess here, doing it here, and it was just a lot easier. It was nice and handy just down the road, so popped in home, crumbed them, and then I shot over here. And we also got some stuff for breakfast. We'll have a look at it later. And a pretty cool beer, which I will show you again soon. You would have seen a snippet of it. Pretty cool looking can. Right now I'm opening up a blue V. And some of you non-New Zealanders will be going, what on earth is a blue V? It's basically New Zealand's Red Bull. Now, I know they're not the best for you. I don't have them much, but it's just gonna help perk me up. That's my excuse anyway, because I'm quite tired from today. I've had a big day at work, so I'll just show you a little close-up of that. Here is the Blue V from New Zealand. That's just a guarana energy drink, and it doesn't even have a flavor blue. It's just blue, but I'm assuming it's just whatever Red Bull tastes like, because they're pretty much exactly alike, except 10 times better. So yeah, I'm just gonna sit here with my Blue V, check out the view, and yeah, come back to you soon. There's a few big Angus and some other cows over there grazing, so I might go for a wander and say hello to them. And of course our pet sheep friend from last time is just up there. He was annoying the heck out of me when I was coming in, because I was trying to set up the tripod, get back in the car, you know, do the driving scenes, and he's running up to the camera and he's nipping the lens and biting the tripod, and I thought, no, I thought he's gonna bite into the lens or do something. So he was being a real rascal. I had to tell him off. He's up there now, sulking, but he'll make his way down. Watch out! Watch out! Don't go near that camera. Hey, hey. Right, I suppose I will show you all what we are having for dinner. I've already told you about it, but I'll show you it all. And of course we'll show you the brew for tonight, which is, I forget where, what brewing company, but we'll have a look at it. Right, let's start off with the brew. Show you the brew that we're having. Now I've only got one of these tonight. Just got the one this time. So I'm not going to be a camping drunk this time, unfortunately. So this is called Posse from Eddie Lion Brewery, New Zealand Pale Ale. And the reason I got this is, check out that can. It's a little caravan with a tarp off the side, a couple of camp chairs. I thought it was really cool. It'd make a cool talking point in the video. So yeah, this is from, it's 4.5% alcohol from Eddie Lion Brewery Limited in Nelson. Ah, never heard of them until this morning when I saw this can. Posse New Zealand Pale Ale, 4.5% alcohol. Smooth tropical fruit and pine New Zealand hops, 100% New Zealand products. Yeah, looking forward to trying that. It's only 4.5%. The reason I brought one, it was $9. Normally I'd get two. I just thought that's going to be enough for me tonight. I'm pretty tired anyway. I don't need to. You know, the beers sometimes help me get to sleep on a rough night, especially when you're in the bush. But yeah, one will do me tonight, so I'm not going to live up to the status of a camping drunk, which some of my, I don't know if you're subscribers or not, some of yous comment that I am a camping drunk and I drink too much. I'm having one beer tonight, not because of you, because I feel like it. Camping drunk, you're right. I have to have a box in order to have that status. Right, what else have we got? Let's have a look. I've got an onion. Nothing special about that. I have these tomatoes. They are called jelly bean tomatoes. Reason being, they're in the shape of a jelly bean. Nothing special about them. They're going with breakfast. I have my lamb chops, which are the star of the show. So I took them home. You can't really see much there. I have a pot of flour, egg, and the panko breadcrumbs, and it's just a step-by-step, three-step to do that and crumb them. I grew up having crumbed lamb chops, and yeah, absolutely love them. And for brekkie, we got some pork breakfast sausages. So I gave myself a budget of $25 for this trip, which I went over by about $12, I believe. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Onion, oh, we got some mushrooms, nothing important there. Got some butter. So yeah, really looking forward to tonight's dinner. Crumb lamb chops are going to be really nice. And I'll be cooking them. Ah yes, I must mention, I got a new cooker. So you would have seen me use the EcoFlow battery last time. Everything was awesome with that, worked super well. I was using it on a sandwich press. So the reason I used a sandwich press last time is basically an hour or two before I even came to this trip, the EcoFlow arrived. So I got it out of the box, charged it up, came out here, had to stop and steal a sandwich press from my mum. I didn't have time to run in to an appliance shop and get a, you know, air fryer or a slow cooker or whatever. But over the past week, I got myself an induction stove, and it's incredible. I set it up this morning, got it earlier today, it arrived in the mail. It can boil water in about 30 seconds. It's just an incredible thing. It does drain a bit of power, but this EcoFlow battery can handle it. I think the induction stove is about 2000 watts, but I've normally been running it at around 1000. There's a setting you can do on it. But anyway, we'll look at that later. So we're cooking on that in the frying pan. Lamb chops, the side of onion, maybe some tomatoes. Ah yes, I've got some potato salad from my deli, local deli in the supermarket as well. So a bit of a feast to have and a nice beer to wash it down. Yeah, so all we need now is a bit of rain. It's looking pretty grey out there, but I have a feeling the rain is going to come quite late tonight. But yeah, beautiful spot to just chill back. I just thought I'd show everyone what's on the forecast. So it's currently a Tuesday, currently nearly 5 o'clock actually. So it's showing the gusts will pick up around midnight, and then they sort of increase like right up till about 9 a.m. when I'm guessing we're going to be leaving. 19 knots with gusts of 33. So it's going to be quite windy, and if we were to hang around, they would get up a little higher, 37, 36. So it's going to be really windy in the morning, the gusts. So I think I'm going to secure the tarp down a little bit more now, just so we're ready. And And hopefully it doesn't go flying in the night, making a whole lot of noise. This one I'm going to bring off the corner. Bring off the corner like that. All I do is create a loop in the end, and we can get another peg for that. Actually, we better check how many pegs we have. Do we have enough? Oh no. Okay, we only have two more. Bugger, should have brought more. Okay, what are we gonna do here? I guess the wind's gonna hit, so we have that one there, and I think I'll do that side. That should be fine. That side needs to be tensioned. Yeah, now that we have shoes on, we can get a real good belt down on our pegs. That one's all right. That one's all right. That one there. Go down in there a bit more. Okay. Ideally one off there, so go cut our guide line a bit more. That's okay. There we go. Alright, and we'll create a loop at this end. Somewhere down there. Need to try my shoelaces. Hearing quite a bit of noise in these bushes. I'm gonna go check if there's any cattle or sheep in there. There we go. So once that tarp actually comes, the tailgate comes down, it's still nice and tight. Okay. Tie my shoelace now. Oh, there's something in this bush. Could be just rabbits. There we go. Set up our table. Go get our stove. Super lightweight, this thing. Make sure I don't trip over on a guideline. Okay. Go. Right, we'll just check that that's working. Turn our EcoFlow on. Okay. we have power. Right, so here's the new induction stove. It's pretty straightforward, super thin, lightweight, and man, this thing heats up quick. You've got to have the special base for these. Unfortunately, that frying pan works. Anyway, you adjust it on your power input. So for example, if I turn this on, set that up there. What we can do is we can turn it on and 1600 watts, 2000 watts, 400 watts. So if you just want to boil water slowly, 200 watts is all you need. I don't think I'm going to be needing over 1000 watts to cook those lamb chops. They're just going to do nice and slow. So pretty excited to cook on that. I haven't really used it. I've only boiled some water with it. So yeah, may be some things to learn with it. It's got a little timer, a few other settings on it. But yeah, it's just a cheap one. I think this was about $34 from Kmart, which is like New Zealand's Walmart, just a shop that has everything. So yeah, excited to cook on that tonight. Right, now I just remembered, a company sent me some stuff about maybe 3 months ago, and unfortunately I just haven't been able to get out camping, but now that I can, I'd like to introduce the Super Sparrow range of water bottles. So they were kind enough to send me, I think they sent me about four. They sent me an aluminium version, they sent me two of these, a green and a pink, so I gave my partner one, Gala. She was very happy with hers. And they also sent a stainless one as well, which is in a bit of a neoprene casing, insulation. These are an excellent bottle. 1500 ml, 1.5 litre or 50 ounces. Just a great bottle, and they've got this feature on the top, which I'll show you up close in a minute. Nice little flip lid on them. Thank you very much, Super Sparrow. And they've actually set up a bit of a discount code for me. So if you would like to place an order, I'll put the link in the description and the comment section of this video. You can get a 15% discount on this by putting SeaWest Camping as your discount code. So if you want a decent sized bottle, 1500 ml, there's a whole range of them to check out. So go and check out supersparrow.com. Right, I'm actually going to fill up my new Super Sparrow bottle. I've been using this one, taking it to work, a great bottle, and 1500 ml capacity, 1.5 litre, which is just huge. Lasts me all day normally. Not that much in there. That way I can keep some water cold and some water can be out with me. Alright, so I'm just going to do half the onion. Save the rest for brekkie. That phone under there. There we go. Big onion. Okay. Keep that in there. I'll just chuck that under there for now. I do have a rubbish bag for my stuff. I never leave stuff behind. Sometimes some food scraps, guilty of leaving eggshells and stuff like that, but I mean, it's organic, but I try not to, especially on the farms where I am. Yeah, we'll leave that like that. All Right, our light is on. I'm going to put some butter in there, so we need our knife. I'm going to get this going. Put our power on at the back. Where is it? I'm still getting used to where the power switch is. Is that it? That's it. We are drawing about 200 watts, which is pretty bang on what it says. Cool. It's more than enough butter. Yes, I'm still figuring out how the induction stove works, because it doesn't actually get red hot. So I don't quite understand the science, maybe, of the word induction. So if you understand how it works, please leave a comment. I'm new to this. I've never used an induction stove, so it's always been gas or old school oven top. See, that's melting that butter so fast, and it's only drawing a low amount. See, it's weird, it's not hot to touch. And it knows when the frying pan's on there. I don't have the packaging, so I can't read how it works. Left it at home, unfortunately. Away we go with the sizzling. I want to get it nice and hot before we put our lamb chops in. Okay. So I've got four big lamb chops here. Just turn it up a little bit. What are we drawing there? 1,000 watts. Okay. Let's go. Nice. We're going to fit them all in. We'll get them in there. Woohoo! So they're going to get golden. Put that up at 1,000 watts. They're going to get nice and golden brown. And then we'll chuck our onions in. Potato salad and a beer. It's going to be a nice meal. Put that down to 600 watts. Put that battery out. Chilly southwest winds dropping to 10 degrees tonight. So 10 degrees Celsius, not sure what that is Fahrenheit. A little too hot, maybe. Ooh. Okay, turn this guy. Oh, thought I burnt them. They're not that bad. One's a little burnt. I'm burning up in the down jacket now. Take it back off. Oh, yum, that smells good. Smells good. And it's gonna be nice with that beer as well. So the EcoFlow's at 70% battery, bearing in mind that it wasn't fully charged, it was at 87%. So since I've been here, I've had the fridge running for constantly for probably an hour and a half, all the way here as well, so that doesn't drain a lot of energy. But we've definitely got enough power. We could do 2 days here with the stove. Oh, it's a great down jacket. I think I talked about it in the last video. The trouble is, you just get so hot. I've been moving around, moving the camera around, and especially with the heat from the cooking, just started to burn up in it. I'm gonna get the onions on soon. The other side of those lamb chops are almost done. Top side's nice and golden brown. One of them's a little bit burnt, but hey, it's all good. It's my first time using that stove. I didn't realize the amount of heat that it was on the 400 watt setting. It was really throwing the heat out, so it's super efficient. And I've actually just got an email from EcoFlow, the company I'm reviewing the battery for, and they're sending me a solar panel charger unit. Someone commented down in the comment section on the last video asking if it could be charged like that solar. And then they emailed me, they were very happy with the video. And they're sending me some solar panels, which I can set up outside. I'm not sure how big they are. And obviously run on the lead, they can be out there charging while I'm draining energy out of it. So pretty cool. It'll be enabling me to do 2-3 days camps, not have to plug it into mains to keep it charged up. Well, we had that light shower earlier, but no sign of any more rain. I would say it's going to come later in the morning. All right. That one off. Up there. That one there. That is a crunchy lamb chop. Perfect. I think two of them are perfect, the other two are a little burnt. Just the crumb anyway. They'll be nice and tasty still. Just test one of these lamb chops, I'm pretty sure. Mm-mm-mm. Perfect. Oh man, it's been way too long since I've had chops. Right, put a couple more on the plate, let them cool down a bit. Put this chop back on, let the underside cook a little bit more. Right, these onions just about done, pretty much are. Just basically crisping up the lamb chops, the fat of the lamb chops now. They're actually done. Just giving the fat a bit of a grill. Get our potato salad out. Now I need a spoon for this. Do I want to have it all now? Yeah, just have it all. Put that there, like that. Rubbish. Right. Onions. Yeah, they're nice. Well done. Just how I like them. Can't get enough onion. Chop am I going to go for? Is it chicken? I think I'm going to go for the best looking chop first. We'll put that one up there and we'll get another nice one, which is probably that one there. Yum. Just try and line them up so they fit a bit better. There we go. Delicious. Right. That's all unplugged. You can live there for a minute. Now I need to get some cutlery. Oh, look at that. Yum. Here we go, there's our lamb chops. Panko breadcrumb coated, fried in butter. Potato salad with bacon, aioli, and some fried onions. Oh, it's great to be back out here though. Beautiful spot, I had to come back. I've just been too busy to do any modifications like I said I was going to. But I'll make sure for the next camp that we'll mix it up a bit, and I'm actually going to use a tent with the van as well, so I won't be sleeping in the van. Have a tent out here or a tent here or something. Need to figure out which one I'm going to use though. Now that sheep's making its way over. I'm not going to be feeding. If he does come over, I'm not going to feed him any of my food. He might be on a special diet, I don't know. All right, stick into one of these lamb chops. This one's got to be the most crunchiest here. Oh yeah, it's real good. Love bread, I love panko crumbs. I do it to all the fish I catch. My favorite thing to do, favorite way to eat it. Mmm. So after dinner, I'm gonna crack open my beer. And we'll have a chit chat about some other channels I've found, other channels I've been watching. And of course, I must say, congratulations to Tony from AB Camping, 100,000 subscribers. Incredible, mate. Tony and Bruce, can't forget Bruce. Well done. 100,000 subscribers, just an amazing feat. And of course, Tony will be getting his silver plaque, I think. Silver play button plaque. He'll be getting that soon. Mmm. Potato salad's good. Right, that's enough of me eating dinner. I'm going to finish this and then we'll come back to you. All right, I've finished dinner, cleaned up everything. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to get my jacket. I'm going to shut this tailgate. Batteries are charging. I'm going to shut this. So that will have to go. That'll be fine. I can shut that. I'll put this over there. And we'll shut the tailgate down. Oh, we need to get our beer. Can't forget that. Now, brewski. It's brewski time. Okay. I need to get rid of that too. All these little things. That's not gonna shut. Do I need to turn that as well? I don't need to shut it the whole way down. Oops. There we go. That's all we need to do. Right, now we can get this. And we can go, what do I want to do? How can I do that? Oh yeah, can we do that? Excellent, so if we just turn that like that, it should provide us with a bit of light. And we can see inside the van. Whoa, there we go. That's my fabric for the top. Sit on that. Alright, I'm going to put my jacket on because it's getting a bit chilly. I reckon 10 degrees tonight with the southwest winds, we could drop down quite a bit lower. It's definitely colder as we hit autumn. Just leave that down for my microphone. Right, we've got our beer. Can I sit down? Yes, I can sit down. Hopefully the lighting is good enough there. I think it is. Should be illuminating my face. Got some nice sunset colours happening. We'll have a look at them in a minute. But first, let's crack open this. Posse Pale Ale by Eddie Lime Brewery. And this is 4.5%, 440ml, smooth tropical, fruit and pine, 100% New Zealand hops. All right, let's go. Cheers, everyone. Thought it was going to be shaken. Mmm. tastes like the last one I tried. What was the other one? Double Vision Brewing. Juicezilla had the dinosaur on the front. Tastes exactly the same. Different company though. Slightly fruity hit. With that distinctive ale background. Oh, that's a really nice brew. Cheers everyone. Cheers to Tony and Bruce on 100k subs. Cheers to Zeb and Jesse, Backcountry Kiwi and Revelo NZ. Go and check out their channels. Two mates of mine, they've just done the whole South Island on foot, which is 1,400 kilometres, I'm not sure. They've gone alpine, they've gone sea level everywhere. And yeah, they've just made it. So cheers to Jesse and Zeb. Well done, boys. And thanks to everyone watching this video at this point. Oh, it's a good brew. The bugs are coming out. I really need to get myself a thermocell. I've had so much stuff on the list I need to get. I've just upgraded my computer, my PC. That was about $1,000 New Zealand to get all the bits. If you're into your computers, I've got a new AMD Ryzen CPU, 32 gigabytes of RAM, whole new motherboard, power supply unit, and a hard drive. But now it's just incredible, the editing. Soon I'm going to be able to do 4K. And the reason I don't film in 4K is because my lens, it gets cropped on my camera. I'm using the Canon M50 and it crops it big time. It's like it's being zoomed in. So if I do want to film in 4K, camera's got to be way back there. So I need to get a lens adapter and another lens. So that's another $400-$500 right there. But I will get around to it and then we can step up to 4K. Oh, that's really good. What a good brew. Really nice. Got some nice colours coming over the top of these hilltops. Reddish, pinkish, purplish colours. You wouldn't know there's a cyclone just off the coast right now. As calm as anything. I think I'm going to get an early night tonight. Pretty tired. Oh, there's one other thing I was going to mention. I've made a new Instagram, which is just Sea West Camping. I think I've got about 50 followers. My first goal is to get it to about 500. So if you don't follow me on Instagram, go and check out Sea West Camping. Give me a follow. I post lots of updates there. Behind the scenes stuff, if you, you'll get a head start on seeing what I'm up to pretty much on my stories and my posts. So go check out Sea West Camping on Instagram. I'd really appreciate a follow on that. I did try and do TikTok, but I'm not really interested in it. I'll just stick to YouTube, Facebook and Instagram. So I've got some other YouTubers downloaded onto my phone, a couple of videos to watch. Some Steve Wallace, the OG, the goat, hunkering down. I'll be hunkering down in the van, hiding from the bugs soon. Watching his latest, which is the camping in a roundabout, I believe. He's crazy, that guy. With his little, two-step. Yeah, no, he does some cool videos. I haven't watched heaps of them lately, but I enjoy his solo trips a lot. Yeah. Cool guy. Really enjoyable videos. And what other videos have I got downloaded? Watch another guy from New Zealand, Mike. Weka Digital Media, NZ. I've known Mike for probably a few years now, maybe getting on 3 years. I actually went and did a trip with him. We did a couple of fishing videos actually. Yeah, really good guy. He's down the east coast in Whakatane in the North Island of New Zealand. So I'll give you a shout out, Mike. He's just started doing a bit of tarp camping and car camping. He's got a lot of bush camps as well. So go check out his channel if you want to support a fellow Kiwi like myself. Go and check out Weka Digital Media. I'll put it right here on the screen. And say hello to Mike. Tell him that Sea West Camping sent you. He's got a lovely dog called Rubber. Maisha. I'm not sure what breed she is. Just a small dog. Real loyal. And goes with him everywhere on his trips. So yeah. Cheers, Mike. Haven't seen you for a while. Maybe we can get out and do a trip one day. Oh, awesome fishing. Haven't done any fishing for a while. All right. Let's jump in. Take our phone with us. It can come off there. Hopefully we don't get too many bugs come in. You go there. Phone can go up there. Beer's empty. She'll be okay. Right. There we go. Yeah, that makes it easier. Audio. Alright everyone, I'm in the van. You should be able to hear me well. I've got the microphone just loose here. Yeah, it's starting to get quite windy and we've had a little bit of drizzle. I've been reading my book for about 30 minutes. Had a bit of a break. Yeah, that wind out there is starting to get, you probably can't hear it, but it's starting to get pretty, I wouldn't say wild, but it will do in the night. I would say we're going to wake up to pretty heavy winds. Hopefully we get some rain in the morning, that'll make it all worth it. But yeah, I've got a few videos to watch. I've got a book I'm reading as well. This one is called Mr. Nice, and that is by, it's an autobiography by Howard Marks, a real life, he used to be Britain's most wanted man in the, I think, early 80s, late 80s, yeah, he had, during the mid 1980s, Howard Marks had 43 aliases. 89 phone lines and owned 25 companies. Yeah, went to prison and was released in 1995 after serving 7 years of his sentence. So yeah, it's a real story anyway. I'm reading that. But yeah, just chilling. If it starts to get quite wild, I'll go out there and try capture some of it. And if it does rain, I'll get up as well, otherwise I'm just going to take it easy. Nice and warm in here, cold outside. And yeah, if anything crazy happens, we'll see you. Otherwise, we'll see you all in the morning. Hopefully there's some rain. Breakfast, we've got sausages, tomatoes, onions, mushrooms. Forgot the eggs. That's all good though. So yummy breakfast. Using the EcoFlow and the new stove. Should be yummy. And yeah, we'll take our time in the morning as well. But it is going to be windy, I think. So let's see if that tarp can handle it throughout the night. Alright. See you in the morning, everyone.
Still raining.
Oh, better get up. Really nice light rain, as you can hear. Sounds different on the roof inside here than it does on the tarp. It'll be louder outside. Alright. Oh, man, it's chilly and windy. Alright, is that unlocked? Yes. Oh. Yep, a lot windier. Is that wet? A little bit. Bugger. Whoa, it's windy. Push that up there. I'm glad I've got my down jacket. Look, it can come back down. Can go on there. Morning, everyone. As you can see, a lot more windier, and we have rain. It's been raining since about 3 a.m. non-stop. Just light rain. It has been quite heavy at times, but yeah, I had a great sleep actually. Nice and warm. It's freezing out here. I've got my down jacket on though, I'll be all good. Oh, it's just gone about 6:40, 6:45, probably closer to 7 now. I'm not in any rush. The forecast is showing the winds to pick up around 8, 9 o'clock quite severely, so we may have to pack up then. Might just get a bit too extreme. I think I'll do breakfast in about an hour's time, maybe 7:40, 8 o'clock or something. Maybe try and get it done before the heavy winds. But the good thing is we're not cooking with gas or flame. We've got the induction cooker, so we don't have to worry about wind for that reason. I'm glad the rain turned up. Our battery at 47 hours remaining, 59% battery. Good old Super Sparrow bottle. Doesn't leak as well, which is nice. You can lay it on its side upside down. Got a good seal on them. Oh. It's going to be a cold winter, this one. I'm not even there yet. Yeah, this is the perfect amount of rain that you want. Just nice and light. Especially when there's a bit of wind. If there's too much, it gets blowing in under. Everything gets wet. Yeah, I had a pretty good night's sleep. I did get up at about 3 and then again at 5 just to see what the wind was doing and the rain. I captured a little bit of rain around maybe, I don't know, 4 a.m. So I've kind of been up every hour almost, but still had a good sleep. That Nature Hike sleeping bag is really nice. Not sure how it's going to go this winter. I haven't actually had a chance to test it in cold conditions yet. I have the -2 version as well. That's the 2 degrees Celsius version. So I have a -2 Celsius version as well. And I can always put my silk Cedar Summit liner inside it to increase the temp rating. But we don't really get too much colder than 0 degrees Celsius here in New Zealand. Oh, here in the North Island, where I am, sorry. I must correct myself there. In Auckland. Middle of the North Island can get really cold, but the South Island is on a whole other level. You know, I figured out this light, this little hanging light. I'm not sure if you can see it. It's got 3 modes on it. It's gone flat now. And the third mode is a candle effect, so it goes like an amber orange and it flickers. So I had that on pretty much all night down the back here, and it was letting off this glow on the back of the tarp like I had a fire outside, so it was quite nice. I need that on. I'll run it flat. That way it charges up a bit better. Right. Get onto that soon. That battery charging. We've got everything charging up. What's that? There's another charger for that. Right. Oh. This place is about to get very busy from tomorrow onwards because we have a long weekend here. It's Easter weekend. So we have Friday and Monday as a public holiday. So this campground has got a whole lot of people coming in Thursday. And they will probably be here till Monday. So I would not want to be here then. Whole lot of noise, kids running around, music. I think there's about 47 spaces booked here, so quite a lot of people. Right, I am gonna get this going. So we want that. And we want our power supply on the back, which is, yep, that's it. So we'll put that on and we'll put that to just 200. I don't need our fridge on. It tastes pretty cold if you keep the lid on it. A little bit of butter. Go. How many do I want to do? I'll just do all of them. If I don't eat them all, I'll give some to the pigs on the way out, I guess. That can go back in the fridge. Those gusts have definitely picked up after 8 a.m. Fortunately, it's not constant 40 knots. That would be terrible, I think. Sausages. Now I'll get my onion on, which is there. And we just got to chuck our tomatoes on at the end. Go off. Turn it off there. There we go. All right, breakfast is served. Cutlery. There we go. That can go off. Right. Pretty sure those mushrooms are done. Ah, this is great. We've had enough rain now to call it a rain video. Beat the wind, so we don't have to do anything else now except pack up. Get another good trip. Pretty late night is this one. I thought it was going to be severe, much more severe cyclone earlier this morning. And I left work and I thought, man, it doesn't look that bad. And what's happened is the whole system has been pushed off the coastline, off towards the east. So where I am here isn't going to cop it anywhere near as bad. So I got all my stuff together, shot to the supermarket, set up the van, because this isn't always set up, so I have to put all the bed frame in, you know, all that kind of stuff. I'm glad I did it all, got out here and did it. Another video for everyone. Alright, as you can hear, the rain stopped. Hold this little table away. Go down there. This battery unit can come that way. What do we got? We've got our batteries there charged. We don't need those. Is that the right one? No. That one, here it is. Charge that there. I'm gonna go give the pigs my scraps. Got some sausages and some onions and mushrooms. If they're over there anyway, they should be. Wow, it's much more windy over here. Hello, how are you? Right, one sausage for you. Here. Sausage for everyone. Sausage for you. Oops. Oops, I hit you on the snout. Sorry, mate. Yeah. All right, have fun. Come here, yeah. You want some of this? Yeah. How are you? You've got a beautiful coat. Beautiful colour. Hey? Hi. Oh, you don't like a head scratch. Oh, I guess I better start packing up. It's really nice in here, comfortable, out of the wind. You'll start getting packed up. Been a great trip though. I'm glad I chose to fit another one in the short time I had to get ready for it. Yeah. Alright. Start by getting the, how would I do this? I guess we're just going to have to start at this end. As we get that out of the way. Now we're going to be dealing with some strong gusts while we pull this down. Chuck all the pigs over there. What I need to do is just basically get this front down as quick as possible, so we're not flapping too much. It's kind of inevitable. This front down like that. Go. Helped having the tailgate up. One more. Knew that was going to tangle. I knew it was going to tangle up. There we go. Right, it wasn't that hard. Put that in there. That can go down there. Battery strength. Okay. Get this tarp a clean. I always give it a clean and hang it out, let it dry in the garage before I fold it away. I try to look after this one, it's been good to me, so just take some time after every trip to clean it. It will last. Right, put our poles. All of them. That can get shut. That can get a wash. Don't need the eco flow anymore. This can all come up the front. Pack that away when I get home. Stay like that for now. See what I mean? It's a nice, easy setup to pack away and set up. It'd be different if I had a tent or some other configuration. Right, We're out of here. Hopefully I don't get stuck. Alright everyone, that's it for this video. If you enjoyed the trip, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to hit the subscribe and leave a comment. Ask me a question, I'll be happy to answer. And if you'd like to donate to my channel, beer, a coffee, check out buymeacoffee.com/SeaWestOutdoors. I'd appreciate a donation to get that going. Alright, see you in the next one.